So you don't see your application in our catalog, but today we're going to show you how to take a couple measurements and fit QA1 shocks to just about anything. Hey everyone, I'm Steve here with Trevor at QA1. Today we're going to talk about measuring shocks for custom applications, things like that. What kind of measurements are we going to need there, Trevor?
Yeah, best determination first though to make would be to determine what mounting styles of the shock you would need. So we want to look at...
So like say if it has an eyelet, T-bar on this one, you know, we've got a stud. So a couple different options that you could run into.
Exactly, yeah. Once the mounting types are determined, that'll allow you to see what shock configuration would be needed. And then that'll also determine the measuring process of the shocks.
So once we know that, you know, we just measure the shocks. Where do we measure them at?
Yeah, the key here is to get the vehicle loaded at ride height. So if you've got the suspension in the vehicle already, you know, leaf springs, coil springs, set the vehicle down at its ride height. That is the key here.
That's the measurement we really want.
Yes, yep, because what we need is we need a shock that is going to have an adequate amount of travel in both directions from that ride height point.
Yeah.
That would limit the chances of it bottoming or topping out.
And then you could even do that right with no shock in there.
Yeah,
you know, if it's sitting at ride height and you've got access to the upper and lower mounting bolt holes, just measure it, right?
Just measure across there at the loaded ride height, exactly.
Center to center. Now on this stud top style, where are we measuring? Because there, you know, sometimes you'll hear measuring to the tip, to the chassis, different areas.
Yeah, the stud top measurement is a little unique. These measurements here can vary from manufacturer to manufacturer. So the key here is we're gonna measure, again, from the center line of the lower eyelet, if you've got the lower eyelet. But on the stud, we're just going to measure to the bottom side of this first washer.
Yeah, this lowest washer here.
Yep, so we're just measuring the actual travel in the shock itself, nothing
above
it.
Sometimes customers will give me the measurement right here between the bushings where it sandwiches the chassis.
Yep.
I just tell them subtract a half an inch and then we're pretty much at that lower washer.
Yeah, so if you've got no shock in the vehicle and you just want to measure to the mounting surface that would be at the center of the bushings, that's fine. Subtract just a little bit off there and that'll give you your ride height measurement.
So are there any applications that maybe we'll run into that we're not going to be able to put these shocks on?
Yeah, so if we've got an import car that runs a specific style clevis mount or a strut mount that would be unique to that vehicle that's not in our catalog, there's a good chance, unfortunately, that we probably don't have an offering that's going to have the right mounting type.
Yeah, those spindle-mounted struts, those are not applicable to this, what we're talking about today. Right. Also the clevis mount that kind of goes over the lower control arm.
Exactly.
Some will call it a U-bracket or an upside down U-bracket, something like that.
Yep.
But today we've got the D100 that we're gonna be measuring up.
Yes.
And it's already got QA1 shocks on it, so we've already gone through this process, but we thought we'd take you along and show you so that you can do it for your application.
Yeah, and this is a 69 D100 here that we've installed a flip kit on it. So it's been lowered pretty substantially from stock height. And if we were to keep the stock length shocks in there, good chance that we'd be bottoming out and ruin the shock. So
yeah. So once we go under the truck and we measure, we figure out what connection types it has, we measure it. Where do we go from there?
Yeah, once we've got that ride height determined, we want to select a shock that would have, I would typically say on a solid axle, we need 2 to 2.5 inches at a minimum of shock travel in both directions from ride height. So,
yeah,
you know, 2 to 2.5 of extension and compression from ride height.
And you may not even use all of that travel, but it's just a safe measurement, safe availability of travel to have both up and down.
Exactly. And you typically need a little bit less in an independent suspension. But the key there is just to make sure we've got adequate shock travel that we're not going to be hitting the bottom or top out point.
And then once you know the measurement at ride height of the shock that you need and the configuration, you know, you can find all of our charts in our catalog on our website. I think they're gonna put one in the link in the description here. So it'd just be a matter of going out, measuring your vehicle, and then taking a look at the charts, figuring out which one has available shock travel, both up and down about 2 inches. And that's it, right? Just order them?
That's really it, yeah.
Easy enough.
Yeah, let's measure this thing up here.
All right, sounds good.
Man, Trevor, you weren't kidding. This thing's low. Anyway, we're under here at ride height. We've got an eyelet style shock. Those salads are really paying off for me today. We'll get a measurement center to center. And we are at 18 3/4. So 18 3/4 is our measurement. Eyelet shock, easy enough.
All right, so now that we know that our shock is 18 3/4 at ride height, we go to our catalog page 19 in the 2021 catalog. You can also find that information on the website, right?
Yes.
It gives all the dimensions of all of our shocks.
Yep.
So 18 3/4, what are we gonna do?
Yeah, so what we're looking for here, Steve, is a shock that would have, you know, at least 2.5 inches or so of travel and compression from 18 3/4, another 2 to 2.5 inches of extension travel from 18 3/4. So if I go down the list of shock offerings here in this eyelet to eyelet configuration, I'd find, a 901 being a good example.
Yeah, and that's a 9-inch stroke. So there's a lot more than our 2 up, 2 down. So we're sufficiently in the center of that one.
Yes, definitely. So at 14 7/8 compressed, 23 5/8 fully extended, we'll be well within the, you know, the required travel parameters there at 18 3/4. That should be a great selection.
And then we just choose whether we want single or double adjustable, but it's all the way around a 901, TS901 or TD901, right?
That is exactly correct. Yep. Another good thing to look at too is determine what size mounting bolts are needed for the vehicle. And then we've got various sleeves, adapters, things like that, that you can custom fit onto whichever shock you purchase.
Yeah, different applications all will have different mounting bolt sizes, whether it's 1/2 inch, 7/16, whatever the case is. Most of our bushings here are 3/4 ID, and we have a lot of different sleeves to reduce down to the mounting bolt size that you're using. Also, this information on our shock lengths and everything, you can find that on our website.
Yes, there'll be tables of the all the listed shocks. The shock dimensions will be on each shock page specific to that shock. So a lot of good information out there for determining the best shock for your application.
So now that we need a 901 shock, we can go out to any of our dealers and order them up. They come in, bolt them on the truck, and we're done, right?
That is it, yes.
Sweet. Well, we hope you learned a lot about measuring shocks today for your custom application that you don't see in the catalog. If you have any more questions, feel free to hit us up on the tech line. You can also send us an email. See us on Facebook, our YouTube channel, which you're here now. Other great videos on tech information regarding QA1 shocks. And until next time, we'll see you then.